What's up, guys? Before the video, I just wanted to quickly let you know about Discord and the ZHouse Discord server. The ZHouse Discord server is a place where you guys can chat amongst each others, with ourselves. We're going to be giving away t-shirts, and Discord in general, it's a place where you can actually like make your own chats and talk with other people. It's a crazy thing. We've been using it to chat with you guys, and I think it's been a pretty big success, so if you want to get in on that, top link down in the description. Anyways, let's get into it. What's going on, guys? It's Patrick here, and welcome back to another Top 10. And ladies and gentlemen, today, guys, we are going deep on the Top 10 Worst Guns to Pack-a-Punch Upgrade in Call of Duty Zombies. As a top 5, this is the most viewed video on my entire channel ever, so I thought it would be a pretty good one to go over again. This time, it's a Top 10, though, and we got Black Ops 3 guns into the list. Also, I'm older, wiser, and marginally better at zombies, so this is actually going to make for an interesting video. Anyways, my mans, let's do it. Coming in at our number 10 spot, ladies and gentlemen, I feel bad putting this gun on this list, but it's gotta be. We have the flamethrower from World at War. So the thing with the flamethrower is it's not a bad weapon. On Nocturne Toten, on Verrucht, one of the most important guns to getting to a high round on those maps. The thing is, though, is the upgrade for this weapon is completely pointless. Now, yes, it does do more damage and it takes more to overheat, but the core point of this weapon is it's only available to be upgraded on Duris, and that's why it's pointless. On Duris, you've got this thing called a Wunderwaffe. It's a one-shot kill forever. The flamethrower was almost a completely useless gun. The only thing that made it actually good was on Nacht and Verrucht, it never ran out of ammo. So you could be on round 100 just training them and you'd eventually be killing the zombies with this gun. But because you've got Pack-a-Punch and the Wunderwaffe on Duris, it makes this weapon 100% useless. Therefore, for that reason, I see no reason to Pack-a-Punch it, and it comes in at number 10. Number 9, the Pharaoh. While it is a Black Ops 3 gun and therefore is able to be double pack-a-punched, I strongly feel like this is the stupidest gun in the entire game. Not all of zombies, just Black Ops 3. Why would you pack-a-punch a Pharaoh? Okay, first off, every single gun in the box is better than the Pharaoh. Everything is better in at least some way than that sack of crap. So maybe you get it because it's a wall weapon and you always want ammo, but like the thing is there's just better options. The RK5 and the LKR9 are lighter, and every other gun on a wall is going to either have more ammo, be more powerful, or shoot faster. There's just no reason that you should ever be pack-a-punching a Pharaoh. So to all you people out there that have been pack-a-punching this gun, I think it's time you take a real hard look in the mirror. Number 8. Never has there been a gun in Zombies that I have been more disappointed about getting than the FAL. Specifically the Black Ops 2 version, but even the Black Ops 1 version is pretty bad. I don't even know why this thing is so bad, but like, just look at it. Just look at it. It's brown. You know what brown is? The color of poop. Not only is it the color of poop though, it's like an off brownish yellow, which almost looks like vomit. And that's basically how I would describe this gun. What's even more weird about this gun is the pack-a-punched version seems worse than the original. The point of the gun is to be a semi-auto, and then they make it burst fire, and it gets weird. Terrible sight, terrible reticle. The FAL is a piece of garbage. Number 7, and this is actually going against everything I just said, the Argus. I feel bad for this one, man. I feel like the Argus has become a meme due to Lex, but it has to be on this list. The only thing the Pharaoh has over the Argus is the fact that it's automatic, kind of. Although a single shot from an Argus is extremely powerful, over the duration of the whole like mechanism of cocking it every single time you shoot it, it gets very slow as an overall damage output. Math and science. Basically what I'm saying is if there's one zombie in your way, it's got a likely chance of killing it, but if you have to take out an entire horde, it's really bad. What I'm getting at is it's the worst shotgun in the game. On top of that, it's got a slow rate of fire, so double pack-a-punch isn't even really that useful. And let's be honest, why would you use an Argus when you could use a KRM on the wall? I'ma just move on. Coming in at our number 6 spot, we have the Gewehr from, you guessed it, World at War. Now, there's not as many guns from World at War as you might think, and that's basically due to the fact that there's very few guns you can actually upgrade in World at War. The Springfield, the Car 98K, the Ariaska, none of them can actually be pack-a-punched without glitches. And that's just because they're not on Duris. The Gewehr is one of those guns that sadly made it onto the map. I don't want to be mean to this gun. It's just bad. It's just not very good. Like, it's just... No, I don't even want to talk about this. Let's move on. Number 5. The L96A1 from Black Ops 2. You know that sniper in Black Ops 1 that every single time you pick it up, you die? Yeah, that one. There's a lot of bad snipers in Zombies. You've got the scoped Kar 98K, the SVG, even some would argue the Locus, the Barrett. But there is no sniper worse than the L96A1. It does the same amount of damage as pretty much every semi-automatic sniper, except you guessed it, it's a bolt action. Not only that, but like, I just feel like this thing has terrible accuracy. Has anyone ever even used this gun seriously? I genuinely think that as far as terrible guns go, this is one of the most underlooked guns in Zombies. It's bad. It's basically one of those instant down guns. And if you were to try to pack-a-punch this thing, especially like no double tap in Black Ops 1, you'd have to be crazy. Number 4. The China Lake! I feel this is just stupid, man. These guns are stupid. Coming in at our number 3 spot, ladies and gentlemen, we have a gun that I haven't talked about in a while. It's a good friend of mine in an ironic way. We've got the SMR. Not the worst gun in all of Zombies, but it's certainly up there. So the SMR is known for being the most inaccurate gun in all of Zombies. When firing from the hip, this thing can hit anywheres in a 420 degree direction. more math jokes. But no. The spread is god-awful, and the iron sights are almost worse. And not only that, but for some reason, the SMR is one of the most non-lethal weapons in all of Zombies. It's been talked about many times before, and I don't know what else to add to it, but it just still confuses me as to what Treyarch was going for. Deep down, I truly hope it was meant to be a troll weapon, it was meant to be a bad weapon, and just the joke of Black Ops 2, because that's where it fit in. I respect the SMR as that. I like it. I like that it's in Black Ops 2. It comes in at number 3. I got no hate for that gun anymore. I respect the troll. Number 2, the Panzerschreck. There's one reason that this didn't come in on our number 1 spot, and it's because of this. And coming in at number 1, ladies and gentlemen, on our list of the top 10 worst guns to pack-a-punch, it was number 1 in the first video, it will be number 1 for forever, it is my man, the Car 98K. Again, it's not even a gun I'm mad about anymore. I just, like I said, I think 2017 Pat, I've wisened up. It's not a gun I'm mad at, I'm just disappointed in. But honestly, I think it's my fault for expecting something from this gun. It's 200 points, it's a bolt-action rifle that can't one-shot a zombie after round 3. Not a lot to live off of, until you pack-a-punch it and you see the name. The Armageddon. And again, I love the fact that it's got this name. It's just like such an icon of World at War. Like literally, Treyarch is just trolling. There's a few interesting World at War pack-a-punch names, and the Armageddon is one of them. They took the worst gun in the entirety of, still, in the entirety of Call of Duty Zombies, in Exos, in Extinction even, in IW, all of Treyarch, everything. And they called it the Armageddon. An Armageddon. The last battle between good and evil before the Day of Judgment. Basically, what it means is the final and ultimate destruction of something in a battle. And you're like, wow, that is so wrongly titled because there's no way the Armageddon is going to, you know, be the final destruction of all the zombies. But think about it. When Treyarch called this gun the Armageddon, they weren't referring to the ultimate destruction of the zombies. No, they were referring to you. If you pack-a-punch this thing, it's over. You need it! We'll be right back.